And last time we discussed about the rock salt and conglomerates. Today we will start with the discussion on other important sedimentary rock. Dolomite is actually a chemical sedimentary rock, and it is very much associated with limestone. It is a sedimentary rock, and it can also be grouped in the carbonate rock group of sedimentary rocks. It is made up of calcium magnesium carbonate. Dolomite is also a mineral, remember, and it is also the name of a rock. So it can be used for both ways. Can be used for naming a rock as dolomite, and also as mineral. So this is its composition. Calcium magnesium carbonate is called dolomite. If it is just calcium carbonate, we call it calcite, and the rock we call it as limestone. So limestone is mostly made up of calcium carbonate, and dolomite is made up of calcium magnesium carbonate. I think we need to remember the difference. Sometimes iron is also present in dolomite as a solid solution, and we call that carbonate, in which iron is more as anchorite. The texture of dolomite is coarsely crystalline. It can be fine crystalline or interlocking crystals. It has the rhombohedral habit. These are some of its identification criteria. But most scientists believe dolomite is secondary in origin, and normally it is formed by the replacement of limestone with dolomite. But in the geological record, in many formations, we have been reported with dolomite that occurs naturally, like primary. It is not replacement. प्राइमरी एंड सेकेंडरी में ये फर्क होता है कि प्राइमरी रॉक जो है वो एज इट इज डिपॉजिट होती है, और सेकेंडरी का यहाँ मीनिंग ये है कि वो रॉक जो है ऑलरेडी किसी एग्जिस्टिंग रॉक से चेंज होकर वो प्रेजेंट फॉर्म में आई है. दैट्स व्हाट द साइंटिस्ट बिलीव अबाउट डोलोमाइट, दैट मोस्टली 98% ऑफ डोलोमाइट इज सेकेंडरी इन नेचर. This is a beautiful dolomite crystals. You can see the beautiful rhombic shape of dolomites that are present here. Similarly, you can see some beautiful dolomite crystals. Dolomite, you can see the dolomite rock, and these are the pieces from dolomite, and they can be used in different chemical industries. But remember, in cement industry, calcite or limestone is more preferred than the dolomite. And normally, in cement industry, they try to avoid any layer that is rich in dolomite. Formation mostly formed from limestone by a simple process of dolomitization, that I said, replacement of calcium with Mg. In that, those waters, the Mg is rich, and it has lesser calcium, and it replaces the magnesium replaces the calcium, and as a result we have the formation of dolomite. The colors, its colors can be rusty, it can have a yellowish color, and normally limestone, remember, is gray color, and most of the dolomites you will find will be rusty colors. It is commonly, as I said, associated with limestones, and it can be interbedded with limestone. And the thing, when you are in the field, you need to have dilute HCl with you, and that HCl can help you to that HCl actually can help you to differentiate between limestone and dolomite, जब आप HCl डाइल्यूट HCl किसी रॉक पे डालेंगे, अगर लाइमस्टोन पे डालेंगे, यू विल सी बबल्स, कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड कमिंग आउट ऑफ दैट. और अगर आप डोलोमाइट पे यू टेस्ट द HCl ऑन डोलोमाइट, then there will be no effervescence, there will be no generation of bubbles, there is no generation of gas, and the acid will act like as water. But that's the basic difference when you go to the field between a limestone and a dolomite. The next important rock is gypsum, and gypsum, as you guys know, the chemical formula is calcium sulfate with water. And the colors, mostly it has white color, and sometimes it also have other colors based on its impurities. If it has iron impurity, maybe the chances are there that it is colored with the red color. Formation, mostly gypsum is formed, as I said yesterday, that in those areas where we have lakes, and in the, those lakes if we have evaporation, and we have the those areas in which there is enclosed basin, there can be a closed basin without any water coming in or out, and evaporation starts in that particular basin. As a result of that, there is a formation of a sedimentary rock. We call it as a gypsum, and the formation results of evaporation, as I said, in sulfate rich salts. Here we can see a beautiful outcrop of gypsum. You can see that the lower layer is all gypsum and the upper layer is limestone. Remember, identifying gypsum is very easy because of its hardness. Gypsum ki jo hardness hai, wo aapka jo fingernail hai, isse bhi aap gypsum ko scratch kar sakte hain. Aapke fingernail ki hardness hoti hai 2.5. और जिप्सम की हार्डनेस होती है 2. तो आई सजेस्ट यू गाइस टुडे व्हेन यू गो जस्ट ट्राई टू सर्च मोहो हार्डनेस स्केल, MOHO हार्डनेस स्केल. तो वो आप देखें तो उसमें तमाम रॉक्स का आपको बताया होगा हार्डनेस के, जिप्सम की हार्डनेस क्या है, लाइमस्टोन की हार्डनेस क्या है, डोलोमाइट की हार्डनेस क्या है. तो तमाम मटीरियल जो कॉमन है उनकी हार्डनेस उसमें बताई जाती है. Okay, here you can see a beautiful example of a gypsum, and it is overlain by the limestone layer, and it tells us that there was at the time of its deposition yahan par jo conditions thi wo stagnant hongi, aur yahan par sulfate minerals jo hain unki abundance hogi water mein, jiski wajah se jab crystallization hui hai to mostly we have the formation of gypsum that is overlain by limestone. Here you can see gypsum quarry. यहाँ पर अगर आप देखें तो you can see a series of these steps, and these steps represents the places from where the mining trucks, after they get filled with gypsum, they travel to the surface. So some of these quarries are having a very good amount of and good number of gypsum layers that can be mined. And in Pakistan we have a very good gypsum deposits in salt range, also in Kohat, also in Balochistan we have very good gypsum deposits, and they are widely used in the chemical industry, especially the those industries that manufacture different types of chemicals, and also I think different type of fertilizers, जो आपकी खादें हैं, इस तरह जितना भी material है उसमें भी gypsum is widely used. It is also associated with rock salt, जो halite है या जो NaCl है उसके साथ associated होता है. इसके independent deposits भी मिलते हैं gypsum के. Anhydride is a variety in which we don't have water, and it is just the calcium sulfate. hydration on anhydride would give gypsum. अगर आप anhydride की hydration करें तो you can find gypsum. Beautiful anhydride minerals that are formed here, and they show beautiful acicular and bladed habits and some mammillary habits you can see there of the anhydride mineral. Anhydride and gypsum, they can be used as a material for fertilizers. They are also essential ingredient for manufacturing of cement, yes, and plaster of Paris and fireproofing component, yes. So these are some of the uses of the gypsum, widely used in the agriculture. Then comes flint and chert. Flint and chert are also sedimentary rocks, and they are not so common, but they can be of very significant importance, especially archaeology. Agar aap archaeological studies karein to usme bahut se jo ancient civilizations thi, they used flint and chert as because of their hardness. Inki hardness zyada hoti hai, so those guys actually used these rocks for the benefit of the mankind. Aur bahut se jo ancient tools hain वो इन मटेरियल्स के बने हुए हैं. एंड इट कंसिस्ट मेनली ऑफ कैल्सिटनी क्वार्ट्स. कैल्सिटनी क्वार्ट्स एक क्वार्ट्स ऐसा होता है जो बहुत ही फाइन ग्रेन हो, लाइक उसको आप उसके ग्रेन्स को आप नेकेड आई से ना देख सको, लाइक अल्ट्रा फाइन ग्रेन टाइप ऑफ क्वार्ट्स वी कॉल इट एज कैल्सिटनी क्वार्ट्स. इट कैन अकर एज कंक्रीशंस और नड्यूल्स इन चाक डिपॉजिट्स. जो फाइन ग्रेन लाइमस्टोन डिपॉजिट्स हैं उनके साथ एसोसिएटेड होती है फ्लिंट. फ्लिंट का ये याद रखें कि ये डार्क कलर होगी हमेशा. इट विल हैव अ डार्क कलर एंड इट इज कंपोज्ड ऑफ सिलिशियस कंपोजिशन. तो इसकी कंपोजिशन मोस्टली सिलिका है. चर्ट इज आल्सो क्रिप्टोक्रिस्टलाइन सिलिका एंड इट हैज वैरायटी ऑफ कलर्स. इट कैन अकर एज बेड्स और लेयर्स एंड आल्सो एज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ नड्यूल्स जस्ट लाइक फ्लिंट. Here we have a few examples of flint and chert. You can see relatively darker color of flint that is present and evident in these layers, and rather lighter color of chert. And these were historically and archaeologically used some of these rocks in the human. Let us see. Okay, then another rock that is of glacial origin, jaise aap glaciers padh rahe hain in your studies in glacial studies, to usme aapne padha hoga ki tillite hai. Tillite actually ek aisi rock hoti hai jo glacial deposition aur glacial erosion se show karti hai, jisko hum glacial till kehte hain. And it is actually structureless, and it has the fragments of various sizes, shapes and composition. Isme sorting nahi hoti, aur ek aur cheez jisko aapne roundness padha tha wo nahi hoti, aur it doesn't have any bedding, proper bedding, and it shows compacted and consolidated form of glacial debris. To jo glacial debris kisi area mein jab glacial sheet aati hai ya glacial ice sheet aati hai, so it deposits all the rocks that it carries with it, and it carries all the material with it. And mostly the matrix or ground mass is of gray and greenish color, and the embedded fragments are extremely heterogeneous. Isme mainly jo matrix hoti hai wo sand or clay or silt ho sakti hai, aur jo fragments hain that are extremely heterogeneous, unki composition jo hai वो काफी डिफरेंट और वेरियस फॉर्म में होती है. लेट्स सी ए ग्लेशियल टिल. हियर वी हैव अ ब्यूटीफुल ग्लेशियल टिलाइट, एंड यू कैन सी देयर इज नो स्ट्रक्चर, नो बेडिंग, एंड इट इज जस्ट लाइक ए हीप और डंप ऑफ द ग्लेशियल. and you can see variety of these guys that are present here. And most of these stones are not that rounded, except few of them, and still they have subangular to subrounded pieces. And in terms of sedimentology or past studies, glacial trilite is a very important type of rock. Okay, here you can see a hammer that has been placed here intentionally. Normally in geological photographs, because you don't know the scale of these rocks, so normally geologists, they just place their equipment in the field to take a photograph. तो अगर आपको इसका साइज का आइडिया है कि ये कितने इंचेस का है, तो उसके हिसाब से आपको पता चल जाएगा कि ये जो आउटक्रॉप है, हाउ मच बिग दैट इज. दैट्स व्हाई वी नॉर्मली यूज दिस टाइप ऑफ स्केल्स इन द फील्ड. यू कैन आल्सो यूज स्केल, देयर आर अवेलेबल फ्रॉम डिफरेंट कंपनीज दैट यू कैन बाय एक्चुअली, एंड यू कैन यूज दोस स्केल्स टू एक्चुअली मेजर दिस टाइप ऑफ सेक्शंस और आल्सो टेक फोटोग्राफ्स. Let's do this, the last one, and then we just finish for today. This is the iron ore. Iron ore are actually very important, and they have been times in the geological past that there was deposition of iron deposits and iron formations in the geological past. And it is also a type of chemical sedimentary rock. We call it as iron deposits. And sometime we have the hydrothermal solution or hot fluids from inside of the earth that also impart iron in different formations. And they can be associated with phyllites, and they can be associated with hematite. We see how it looks like. You can see that there is the presence of the reddish layer is actually representing iron rich layer, and they can be mined. And here you can see an iron oxide ore that has been processed, that has been grinded, and then it will be separated using different metallurgical techniques, and it will be processed through some chemical processes that will help us to differentiate and to make the separate and to separate iron from its gang rock. Well, that's all. Yes, we are left with the engineering importance. We will do it tomorrow, the next class. Until now, I think that is enough. If you guys have any questions that are relevant to the class, you guys are welcome to ask. Okay. If you guys have any confusion? Okay, Zareen, you can ask. Come again. आपकी आवाज बहुत कम आ रही है, can you please repeat?
सर, लाइमस्टोन और डोलोमाइट का डिफरेंस बता दें दोबारा से.
Okay, we can discuss the difference between limestone and dolomite again. Let us see the slides again. Limestone and dolomite are very similar origin rock. और इसमें फर्क ये होता है कि जो limestones हैं, normally they are formed let me go to the slide so we see the limestones again. Where is that? Yes, oh, we can see the limestone again. Let us go full screen. Limestone is normally a sedimentary rock that is consists mostly of one mineral that we call it as calcite, calcium carbonate. However, dolomite is calcium magnesium carbonate. So this is the basic difference that is in composition. And there is another difference. Calcite is a mineral, limestone is a rock. Dolomite is a mineral, and dolomite is also name of the rock. ठीक है, इसके अलावा इनमें फर्क ये है कि जब आप फील्ड पे जाएंगे या आपके पास हैंड स्पेसिमन है म्यूजियम में, आप डिफरेंस करना चाहते हैं बिटवीन कैल्साइट मिनरल और डोलोमाइट मिनरल या लाइमस्टोन और डोलोमाइट में. तो कैल्साइट जो है या लाइमस्टोन नॉर्मली उसके ऊपर जब आप एसिड को ड्रॉप्स उसके गिराते हैं तो उसमें से यू विल हैव द बबल्स कमिंग आउट एंड कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड कमिंग आउट ऑफ दैट. जबकि जो डोलोमाइट मिनरल है इस पे जब अगर आप रिएक्शन करते हैं उसका HCl का, देयर विल बी नो रिएक्शन एंड द एसिड विल लुक लाइक वाटर ऑन द सरफेस. सो दैट इज द मेन डिफरेंस. अदर डिफरेंसेस आर देयर दैट नॉर्मल द कलर ऑफ द लाइमस्टोन इज लाइट ग्रे टू डार्क ग्रे, बट इट इज अ वेरी रफ क्राइटेरिया टू डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन लाइमस्टोन एंड डोलोमाइट. And dolomite will be brownish you can call it as a tan color rather than the gray color. Well, that's the difference between dolomite and